Today, we will learn to create charts in Python, using PyPlot library. We will use Google Colab, for Python programming. Let's open Google Drive, and start our exercise. To create a new notebook, click on the New button in Google Drive. And from More select Google Colaboratory. You can rename and save the notebook in your Google Drive. The saved file will be available in your Google Drive, which you can access later. We will use the PyPlot library to create visualizations, therefore we must import this library first. Let's define some lists of integers, to use in our charts. First, we will define a variable n, containing a list of numbers from 1 to 9. The variable x will also contain the numbers from 1 to 9, but they will not be in a sequence. We can use the plot function, to create a simple line chart. We need to provide the data, to plot the line chart. Run the script to display the result. However, it is recommended to use the figure, from PyPlot library, to create charts. To use the PyPlot figure, we must first define the one in our code. We must also define a subplot, to draw our chart on. Now, let's draw a line chart using that subplot. The result is same, but now we have a more flexible script, where we can define more features such as labels, legends, colors, etc. We can simplify the code, by defining figure and subplot in the same line. This will produce the same result. We can use the setTitle function, to display a title over a chart. So here is our title. We can also define labels for our axes, using setXLabel and setYLabel functions. Now both axes have labels, as defined in our code. To display a legend, we can use the legend function. Here, we need to define the items that we want to display in the legend. We can convert a line chart into an area chart, by using stack plot function. To display a bar chart, we simply need to use the bar function. We can add h at the end of bar, to display a horizontal bar chart. We can display a line chart, and a bar chart, in a single chart as well. We can use the step function, to display a step chart. To display a pie chart, use the pie function. Let's comment out the axis labels. We will assign the list in variable n, as our legend. And this is our pie chart. Each color in legend represents their respective slice in the pie chart. You can also display the value of each slice in your pie chart. We can use the scatter function to display a scatter chart. Let's define the legend as X. A scatter chart displays data in points. Let's define a new variable, containing a multidimensional list of integers, with minimum, average and maximum values. We will use the boxplot function, to display a boxplot, based on data defined in variable b. The data is same as variable x, but it also contains the upper and lower limit. Let's plot a line over our box plot, to compare both variables. As you can see, the line fits exactly over the box plot. Similarly, we can use the violin plot function to display a violin plot, which shows upper and lower limits of data. Let's remove the line from our violin plot. You can also use spectrogram to display your data. You can create a spectrogram using the spectgram function in PyPlot. A spectrogram uses color to display intensity of your data. Now, we will display a histogram. First, let's define a variable h, containing a list of integers and their frequency of occurrence. The repetition of an integer represents their frequency of occurrence. We can use the histo function to create a histogram from our data. You can also define the bucket size in a histogram. The bucket size is adjusted according to the number of buckets we define. The Hexbin function is used to create a Hexbin chart. A Hexbin chart is used to display a very large number of data points, overlapping each other. The data we use to display Hexbin is small. Let's use number pi to generate a large number of data points. Let's use the random function in NumPy to generate 10,000 random values. Let's display this large data using Hexbin. Let's use the standard normal function to generate probability distribution of 10,000 random values, and display those using a Hexbin. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.